Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to the Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. We're here at Dubai Watch Week 2019 with John von Steen, CEO of Meistersinger Watches. John, welcome to the show.
Hi, welcome, Tim. Hi. Nice to meet you. Nice to be here.
Nice to be acquainted, both with you and your watches. Now, we were talking off camera about some of the most interesting brands being founded by non-watchmakers. Max Bucer, an engineer. Richard Mille, a businessman. Benoit Mintians, Ressens, an industrial designer, and Meistersinger, founded by Manfred Brossler in 2001, also an industrial designer. How does that inform the aesthetic of a Meistersinger watch?
The aesthetics of a Meistersinger watch is influenced by, of course, the history of time. We consider ourselves as the origin of time because the single hand, that's where it all started with. Only look at, think of the sundial. The first church clocks had only a single hand. And the design of the Meistersinger is coming from a measurements instrument. And looking at the needle hand with the overhaul. And that influences the thoughts of Manfred Brossler when he designed the initial concept of the Meistersinger back in 2001.
And now you've evolved beyond the one hand. You have quite a few watches with dates, with jump hours, even with moon phases.
Right.
I think that's an interesting transition into one of the novelties you've unveiled this year. Could you tell us a little bit about the Lunascope that we have here today?
So the Lunascope is a model which we introduced in 2018 with the Silver Moon, and back in this year at Baselworld 2019 with the Golden Moon. And this is a moon phase which is exceptionally big for the watch industry. It's a three-dimensional moon phase with a photorealistic picture of the moon. And once the moon is set correctly, it will run for 128 years accurate.
Now, it's an enormous moon, but it's a nicely sized watch. 40 millimeters, you were saying?
40 millimeters in the Pangea case, which is our case, which is in our elegant line. So not, let's say, the sporty line as the number three in the paragraph, but it's more in the elegant line.
Now, you have two watches here today, three if you count the one on your
right,
wrist.
Yeah.
But I think the one that's the star of the show, at least for Meistersinger here in Dubai, is a limited edition released in conjunction with Siddiqui. And I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about the Circularis Reverse and what makes it special.
What makes it special is when you look at the watch, it's more or less the standard Circularis, which we introduced back in 2014 as a hand wind. And back in 2016 as an automatic version. But if you take a closer look at the watch, you can see that the numbers, the Arabic numbers on the dial, are not as they used to be with the normal lines. So it goes from the 12 to the left, 01, 02, 03. So it's a reverse. So the hand is going counterclockwise.
And it's a gorgeous look. I have to say, there's a little bit of almost an off-white tinge to the numerals. How did you get that off-white? Because it's not the same silver as the case itself. It almost has a little bit of an undertone of gold to it.
Yeah, right. They're not real gold appliques, but they are appliques. And they are in 4N quality.
And, you know, of course, regionally appropriate, not with gold on the dial. Nevertheless, you get that nice contrast between the off-white of the hand, the 4N rose color of the numerals, and then you've got a three-dimensional effect as you have at the top the hand, then the numerals, then the blue, the matte blue of the dial, and then the date disc itself. Was it a big transition for the company to add a date and laterally a jump hour? Was that a big transition aesthetically, or was it something that you saw as a logical continuation?
The date is a logical continuation for the brand, because if you have, and we noticed that the consumers still highly appreciate, and they always in our top five of best-selling models, let's say our classic pieces, the number three, number one, which means dial, hand, nothing. So plain, simple, pointing out the time with a single hand. But there are also consumers who appreciate a little bit more in the watch, and that more can be a date, that can be a day date, that can be a moon phase. Yeah, we have several options, and of course the jumping hour.
Now, the watch is a limited edition, 25 pieces, I believe.
Right.
43 millimeters in stainless steel.
Yeah.
But once you get past the dial, which is impressive, the movement may be even more so. Could you tell us a little bit about your exclusive caliber?
Right. This is the MHA-01 movement. It's our automatic own movement. We don't call it manufacture, because if you call it manufacture, you make everything by yourself. We are a German company, so that means we are straightforward and we say what it is. It's our own movement. We designed it. We assemble it. Yeah? But we buy the parts according to our specifications at our suppliers.
Now, it's a very handsome movement, yeah. But I'm going to shout out the 5-day power reserve as a standout feature. Yeah. How did you decide, after initially using ETA movements with 38 yeah. to 42 hours, that your first movement wasn't just going to be an exclusive piece, but it was going to be 5 days? That seems like an impressive jump. Did you decide, yeah. say, we didn't just need to replace the ETA, we needed to add technical capability with our first movement? Mm-hmm.
It was perhaps going by accidental, because we had the opportunity. We had the opportunity to design the movement according to our wishes, and we had the opportunity to add a longer power reserve. So if you have the opportunity and you look at the cost, etc., and the costs are within our price range, of course you add that power reserve.
So now you have both manual wind and automatic wind versions of this movement in yeah. your various watches. And I guess it's worth mentioning that your brand is a little bit difficult to pigeonhole, because it doesn't fit into any real category in the watch space. You're an independent.
Yeah.
So you have what's in common, I guess, with independents, ranging from the one-man shop decorating things in the Vallée du Jeu by hand, right up to the Richard Mules and the F.P. Journes of the world. What's it like as an independent trying to reach out to the client? Do you see these smaller regional shows like Dubai Watch Week as the future of the trade show?
Absolutely. Absolutely, because what you see on regional trade shows or regional shows like the Dubai Watch Week, but also Watch Time New York, Watch Time LA, Salon Coupé in London, that you have a direct contact with the customer. And we, as a small brand, we often have the difficulties, if you look at a high-end retailer, that they are so stuck with the high-end brands, and those are so demanding that there is little less space for smaller brands like a Meistersinger. But going to that show like Dubai Watch Week, like Watch Time, you notice that consumers are eager to see those brands, because they don't want only to buy major brands, but they want to see something different, something unique. And therefore, you see the enthusiastic reactions of the consumer here at Dubai Watch Week for also the independents, not only Meistersinger, but also a brand like Arm & Strom, who's next to us. You see the consumer smile that they find something which is really interesting and intriguing for them, and actually they want to buy it.
And they get to put the watch on the wrist. It's not like you have to see it in glass if it's
absolutely
if you went to Basel.
That's when you look at big shows like Geneva and Basel, there is always a big blockage to enter a booth.
Yes.
We always try when we
Do
are
Do you
at
have
Basel.
An appointment?
Right.
No.
No, you're not on the list, sorry. You cannot touch the watch. Go outside. Then the consumer can also go to the retailer. And when he enters the retail without appointment, he can wear the watch. So what we always do during Basel is, of course, they cannot go into the rooms of where the sales conversations are being held. But we have a podium where they can wear all the novelties, put them on the wrist and look and make pictures. Because it's all about, in the end, it's all about the consumer.
So you got to get yourself to Dubai Watch Week next year. That's the lesson right there.
Yeah.
Quick question about a watch that's not represented on the table or on your wrist, because I think it's important to note that you don't just make dress watches and casual watches. You do have some fairly committed sports watches.
Right.
You're talking about the Saltora Meta X, mm-hmm. which is not a diver, but it's a heavily swimmable jump hour with a rotating bezel, an awesome size, awesome fit, a bunch of color options. One of my favorite colors
that's
and
green.
Probably one of
yeah.
my next watches. Tell us a bit about how you got to the Meta X, because it's so different from your other watches, all of which were kind of genteel, and it's a bit rough and tumble.
The Meta X is the successor of the Meta. It's a successor of the Saltora. Saltora means jump, hour. Salto is jump, ora is hour. And we developed that model back in 2013. We introduced it in 2014. And why we introduced it, till that time, Meisterzinger had also two-hand watches. But obviously the consumer knows that Meisterzinger stands for single-hand watches. So we decided, okay, two-hand watches is obsolete within the Meisterzinger collection, and we do only single-hand watches. However, with the jumping hour, we could offer a single-hand watch to those consumers who said, yeah, I like Meisterzinger, but I want also the minutes, because on the Saltora Meta X you can read the minutes. And that's the reason why we developed the jumping hour.
Now, at the end of the day, your brand is not universally distributed. It can be a little bit tough to find it. I heard you might be working on an online shop. Is that still in the works?
That's in work. That's in the United States. It's in progress, meaning that it should be online within any day now. We are already online in Germany, and of course, because that's our home market, in Austria and the Netherlands. And now the US is, let's say, the first export country where we do that online shop. The nice part about our online shop is we do it together with our retailer. That means a consumer is buying a watch at the online shop. We send it directly to that consumer, but the retailer who is the nearest gets his provision. And the provision is a fairly high amount.
And then you maintain a relationship with the retailers.
Exactly, because what we feel is that the watch industry or watches and also jewelry have to be sold in that personal context. Because we talk about emotion.
Yes.
And we all know that internet has a lot of advantages, but emotion is not one of them. Emotion is when you talk face to face about the product. You feel it on the wrist. Yeah. So, but there are consumers who said, no, I'm not interested in that part. I want it just order it online. But the contact and the after sales, etc., has to be taken care of by the retailer. Because that's for us, but not only for us, but for, I think, all of the brands, essential in our sellout, that you have offline sales.
And offline customer service.
Right, yeah.
John, thank you so much for coming on the show.
You're welcome. Thank you, Tim.
Meisterzinger watches, designed in Munster, Germany, built in Switzerland, now available in the US on their online shop. And I must say, one of my favorite jump hour watches of all time. Time out, Tim out, and thanks for logging on.